Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I want to talk to you briefly about, do fibroids shrink after menopause? Have you heard that before, fibroids shrinking after menopause? I'm glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knutson. I'm a certified holistic health coach, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female-related conditions. So I would love it if you would subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. So, fibroids after menopause, do women still get them after menopause? Do they shrink after menopause? Can they flare up after menopause? And the answer is yes to all of those questions. But I can tell you that I have never spoken to a woman that has told me with her lips that the fibroids she had in her body shrank after menopause. I've never heard it. But I do get questions often related to, do fibroids shrink after menopause? Because I have women with fibroids, they are either in menopause or they're post-menopause and they still have fibroids and they're still having symptoms. I talk to many women who are in this type of situation. I even have women who have contacted me and they're even in their 60s and they're having breakthrough bleeding because of fibroids. A lot of times women's doctors will tell them, you know, don't worry about the fibroids because you're going through menopause or you're getting ready to go through menopause. They're going to shrink. Don't worry about it. So in fact, a woman will just believe what the doctor is telling them. And so they don't do anything about it. And I do believe there are some cases where fibroids do shrink after menopause because of the estrogen levels that are in the body after menopause. But this does not always happen, so do not bank on it. I would go as far as saying that most of the time this does not happen. I believe that the reason that the doctors are telling women that the fibroids are going to shrink is because once we go into menopause, our estrogen levels in our bodies decrease. Therefore, they say that because fibroids grow when there's an excess of estrogen, that they think that in the surge of estrogen that the fibroid is actually going to shrink. And that may be the case in some people. But a lot of people are estrogen dominant because of what they eat, what they drink, what they think, what kinds of products they're putting on their bodies, and their body is also producing estrogens. And a lot of these products that we use, the foods that we eat, disguise themselves as estrogens, like, so they're fake estrogens or xenoestrogens or chemicals mimicking estrogen. So that's what causes the fibroids to grow in the first place, or the PCOS, or the endometriosis, or the fibroids in the breast, or, you know, the list goes on with the female health issues. So yes, after menopause, our naturally occurring estrogen does drop, but did we stop eating the estrogen-laden foods, the water supply that's full of chemicals? Did we stop thinking the negative thoughts? Do we still have a high stress environment? Do we still put toxic chemicals in our cleaning? Do we clean our homes with toxic chemicals? Do we still put toxic makeup and toxic body care products on our bodies? And most of the time, the answer is no. So therefore, you're still being bombarded with lots of different estrogens that is causing those fibroids to continue to stay or to grow and become worse than they were even before you went through menopause in some cases. So how do you fix this problem? One of the things is that we have to stop being estrogen dominant. So the same things I suggest that women do before menopause to shrink fibroids naturally is the same thing that I'm going to suggest after menopause to shrink fibroids naturally. And the first place to start is with the food. And that's all I'm going to cover in this particular video. We'll go into more detail in future videos, but we have to stop eating the foods that contribute to fibroid growth. That's meat, dairy, alcohol, caffeine, estrogen-laden foods, chemical-laden foods, processed foods, sugars. And if you want more detail about which foods to avoid, I have a PDF that you can download. The link is in the description box. It's called The Foods to Avoid to Help You Shrink Fibroids Naturally. Download that ebook for free, and it will give you some idea as to what foods to avoid and a little bit of information as to why you should avoid these foods. And I would go back through my YouTube channel and look at the videos about the types of things that you can do to help yourself to shrink fibroids naturally. Because it is not a guarantee that you go through menopause and those fibroids be gone. Especially if you're doing everything in your life the same way you were doing before menopause that contributed to the fibroid growth in the first place. So the first place I suggest is starting with food. It probably is the hardest place for people to start because of food addiction. And I know this because I have been in that rabbit trail of food addiction. I understand how it is. You know that certain foods are not good for you, but you eat them anyway. And it takes a huge mindset shift. And that's why I think it takes so long for people to get well from women's reproductive health issues, because they have the issues with food, and it takes time to change that process in your mind and your soul and in your environment. You know, you have to change your whole life. So if you are a woman and you still have fibroids and you have entered menopause, or if your doctor has said, don't worry about the fibroids, they're going to shrink in menopause, please comment below. I would love to hear about that. Also, if you have no clue what it is you should eat to help you shrink fibroids naturally, I have a 7-day meal planner that you can purchase. It's down in the description box. You can also go back through my YouTube channel, watch my recipe videos. Start to change what you are putting in your mouth, because it starts there. And then once you start getting into that, you can start changing some other things. And we'll talk about those things in time, but just start with your food. Because I'm telling you, you can do all the other things you want to do. And if you keep on putting food in your mouth that causes estrogen dominance, then there's not much hope for changing your situation. You can take herbs, you can do all these things, but it doesn't help when you keep on putting things in your body that's negating what you're trying to do that's positive. So anyway, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Don't forget to subscribe. And until next time, y'all, take care.